banana TV.
You get to how long first? Maybe 2 years? A couple of years. Yeah, and then mum's like, I'm not watching those slaughterhouse videos. I'm not going vegan. This is another fad, that kind of thing. She's pretty supportive as well, but she wasn't going to do it.
That's good, because then we got more
quality,
serious people. Like, we had over 500 people last year. That was awesome, but it's a lot of time wasted with people who aren't that serious. They're interested, but they're not committed. If you get up here, if you get up in the morning before 6 o'clock and ride your bike up here, you're fucking committed. No doubt about it. Especially if you're looking to bring up a hill. You know, in the humid weather. That's commitment. So we're here for committed people. So with your family and friends, a lot of people might show interest, but if you're not showing commitment, don't be committed. Just calibrate your effort to their effort. Otherwise, you can spend the rest of your life trying to want something for someone more than they want themselves. I mean, I could move to Wagga Wagga, New South Wales, Australia, you know, hook up with some chick who's just like me, and I can spend the next 20 years trying to convince them why they should get on YouTube, why they should ride a bike, why they should go vegan. And I could not. That could be a reality. And I could give, and she go, oh, no drug problem, oh, no worries, I'll give you money, like, we'll pay for the rehab, and oh my god, you ring relax here some more. I could waste my whole fucking life. And all of us here could circle freely. As an extreme example, so just be careful how much time you give
to people.
So it's the reality, man. Like, it's just, we choose our reality.
Yeah, so just drop the bomb and leave. What's that?
Just curious, are you really married?
Nah.
Married, no.
No?
No, we don't need a piece of paper. You know what I mean? Like, and I don't want to break up and have to give him up. No, but seriously, like a piece of paper.
If you believe in marriage, that's cool as well. Like,
yeah, if you want to do that.
Do what you want in life.
We don't want to do that.
The only problem in life is living the life you don't want to live. So if you want to do anything in life, you do that. The only failure is doing what you don't want to do. Don't worry about what we say, what your parents say, whatever. Like, you do what you want to do. You do what you want to do, what needs to be done for the planet. That's what fucking matters every day. Sure.
You wear socks?
No, I don't wear socks in Thailand. When I run, I do, to avoid blisters, but when I cycle, I don't. My feet stink more, but I find it stays cooler. Like yesterday, I did the backside of Doyington. Who's done Doyington? Man, fearless, alright. Who's done the backside of Doyington? Yeah, it's next level. Where's Vigo?
Vigo.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, water run. Yeah, so,
I said he's in love.
So like, Vegard told me about the backside of Doyington, and it's got like next level. Like, Doyington is like easy compared to this. Like, it's insane.
So, have you gone down?
Oh, I didn't go back down. I took the easy way back home.
Yeah.
Lost the side, I didn't climb that
hill. I didn't like going down.
Yeah, yeah. This is next level. So, it's full on. Sketchy. So yeah, I stay cooler by not wearing socks. So I don't recommend wearing socks. But if you're gonna get blisters, bring some socks with you, because you don't want to be riding home with blisters.
Do you guys remember like your first time
you did the mountain, like what was like going to death? Yeah, like to like see how your progress is, like gone from there. That's a good thing about Strava. You know, you can look back at your first time that you did, and compare it to now.
The first time I did Doyce attempt was December 2010, and I put out a couple of Thai guys, and then it's not a hard climb, it's a bit casual compared to Doyce. I remember the first time I did Doyce, definitely, because there's so many fogs, peaks, you think, oh, this has got to be the end. Even yesterday, I was like, oh, this is the end, right? And it's like, guys, it's like, it's traumatic. It's triggering. Yeah, if you got any issues mentally, like, we'll sort it out. If you say I've got problems in life, I'm like, do the backside joints and all. It's the hardest climb in the world, I reckon. I would fly to anywhere in the world if someone could show me a climb that's harder than the backside of joints and all. It took me 5 hours 22 from the start of the climb to the top. Obviously, I was stopping for photos and patting cows, but. If I was going full gas, maybe 4 hours 30.
Yeah.
What about
makes it so hard? So you just want to hold it down?
These 19% ramps. Just keep going and going and going. Then you go back down and then you go up. So your legs cool down and then they go up more water again. So it's just like half of it now. So it's really epic. Yeah, it's interesting. I was just going easy, but still for a lot. So, no, it's good. It's so good.
Well.
I only had a 32, so I'd recommend something better than that. It's a good climb. It's definitely, only five people have done it on Strava.
And you're one of them.
Oh, I don't think he's on the line.
You left.
What's the best time?
4:22 or something.
I don't need to be abused online.
So who's from USA? And so you can have a look around. So
I can't find the paperwork.
Alright. Jamaica. Who's from Jamaica? Italy. Italy. France.
Yeah.
España. Spain. Spanish. Portugal. Canada. Australia. New Zealand. Switzerland. Austria. Belgium.
Can someone do like a head count?
Israel.
Taiwan.
China. Thailand. And we've got, what about the Scandinavians?
Yeah. Sweden.
Finland. Dutch. Dutchies.
Anybody from Africa? Ivory Coast?
Where did you fly from?
I flew from London.
Yeah.
But I'm really from my very good family.
I wish I had your skin, man. Like, you got cooked yesterday.
Yeah,
I'll just really buy, if I can buy skin transfer, I'll buy $100,000. I'm serious,
I'll
like a backpack mask, like sunburn mask. I was like, it's overcast, it's raining, it should be right, it's only 9 o'clock now. Ireland.
Yeah.
Scotland. I think UK tonight. England. And then we've got all the small Euro countries like Lithuania. Czech. Greece. Estonia. With Jacob here, is Jacob coming to see?
He's here.
What other countries have we got?
Japan.
Russia. Luxembourg. Wow. I was going to say Luxembourg, but Luxembourg's a beautiful country. Looks like there, it's really nice. Very green. What other countries have I mentioned here?
Iceland.
Greenland as well.
Greenland. Venezuela. If I haven't mentioned your country, shout it out.
Poland.
St. Martin.
St. Martin. Is that it?
Bulgaria.
We got international. International crew, man. It's awesome. We'll come to Thailand, the car will fuck up and get it done.
Yeah, so far, any questions you have about us?
Shut up. Social media is changing the world. Nothing's like more powerful than social media. In the US, social media is getting more hits than TV now. YouTube's getting bigger than TV in the US.
Yeah, that literally happened in the last 2 weeks. Like, YouTube overtook mainstream media for views. So it's all changing now. So if you're not like jumping on board YouTube now, you're crazy. It's gonna jump on. This is the time.
So it's pretty epic.
Don't miss out.
It's pretty epic.
And the thing is, like, don't think, oh no, there's already heaps of vegan channels. Like, you've got a unique personality and everybody wants to listen to different people and different approaches. So don't think you're not unique and that you can't succeed. Everybody here can succeed if you do the right thing. What's that? You are. Just like, seriously, do the celebrity videos. It will, like, you know, the aim is to get above all the channels. You know, you're buried currently. If your channel's quite small, you're buried beneath all these channels. You just got to get up to the top, and that requires like celebrity videos, like celebrity YouTubers or celebrity mainstream. It works. I've shown it works, you know. So just do it. Absolutely. That's if you want to make money, make an impact on the planet, help people, help animals. That's if you want to do that. I do. You all can succeed.
So every day we'll do the Q&A here from 8 to 9, and then 9 o'clock, do your thing.
Every day is Q&A.
Every day is Q&A unless it's pissing down the rain. And then just take that time to recover and catch up on videos or whatever, making content. Any more questions?
I got a quick one.
Yeah?
You sort of just touched on it, but like, do you see a point where, like, let's say someone's new to YouTube, they're putting out like 2-3 YouTube videos a day. Do you think after a year that they'll, you know, be getting a good following after a year? Like, how long?
If you put out a video every day for a year, you're definitely going to get a decent following. But I see people put out sporadically, like they'll go every day for like 2 weeks and then you won't see them for 2 weeks. But if you're every day consistently, even like 2 a day, you're definitely going to get a following. But you just be good to do celebrity ones too.
Yeah.
No, you just follow what other
YouTubers are doing.
Yeah, you just do a video on the celebrity as well because they want a different approach. Everybody wants to see different personalities. So you're unique in that way. And like just really let your personality out and like amplify your personality. Make it interesting. Don't be like, and then she ate a chicken leg, and you know what I mean? You don't want to be boring, you don't want to be monotone, you want to be like...
More drama.
Yeah, drama, just have fucking fun, you know?
And so if you want to leave the Q&A any time to talk, do so. But if we can avoid talking at the back, it's harder for everyone at the front to hear. So if you want to talk amongst yourselves, that's cool. That's all right. But you don't have to stay here if you come here. You can walk off and talk. This is hard for the people trying to hear, if people at the back are talking. But feel free to talk. We just talk it to her. Does that make sense? Otherwise, we have to talk loud.
Just
and
shut
then,
the fuck up.
And then our voices will be cooked. But you're fine to leave and have the conversations. Because this event is basically for people to meet each other and hang out, yeah? And most of us probably know the same shit we say every day. But this event we put on to build community. You know, so this is the only reason we're here. You know, we're not here to make money. We're here to build fucking community. So we understand people, you know, excited and want to talk, and that's awesome. That's what we encourage. But at the Q&A, we'll try to keep it silent so everyone can hear. But if you want to come to Q&A and talk, that's awesome. But just... That can be the talking area over there, even. It's a beautiful garden to meet people and chat.
Do you guys want to talk about, like, sort of cultural things? Yeah,
Thai culture. Yeah. It's a lot of mixed opinions on it. Generally, when I'm up here, I put my shirt on because, you know, RawTill4 is quite a spiritual place around here. If I'm doing a TT, I have my shirt off. But as soon as I come up here, I put it on. When I go into 7-Eleven, I put my shirt on. And I generally have my shirt on in the city
Generally, it seems like if you're sort of biking up, it's like...
It's a grey area.
Yeah, or if you're in like a park or something like that.
If you're doing exercise.
Yeah, they sort of understand that. But yeah, outside of the temples and like...
Yeah. You're not going to get arrested, but it's just a culture respect thing. So I generally snap my shirt on once I get up here.
Also, your feet. Be mindful of your feet.
Yeah.
The feet are like, it's like the lowest, you know, part of your body. Like, it's dirty. It's viewed as like, so if you're in 7-Eleven, like, I was in 7-Eleven one time, and I was like, I was with my girlfriend, and she's tied. I was like pointing at a bag of chips with my foot. Like, I didn't know. And there was like an old lady down there, like, looking at stuff. And she was like, no, like, don't do that. The old lady looked at me and she was like,
yeah.
So, like, he's got a, I don't know. And also the king, the royal family.
Oh, yeah.
Any pictures of the king, anybody talks about, like, you know, you got to respect the royal family.
Yeah. Basically, if you saw a picture of the king and threw a water bottle at it and a cop saw you, you got to prison.
Oh, yeah.
Like, YouTube was banned in Thailand because someone made a video making fun of the king. So, don't go there with the king. Keep your shirt on in the shops or at the temple.
Even if a coin falls with the king on it, don't step on it, you know.
Yeah, drop a coin, don't put your foot on it, because the king's face on there. Or a bill, you know, we're used to that. If you drop a bill, you know, it's like, I don't want to fly away, so I'll just step on it. Not cool,
huh? This is the thing, this common sense stuff.
Yeah, but it's not really common. People don't know that stuff, so let's figure it's worth
good reminder.
If there's anything else that people can think of, there's lots of things to pick up as you go, I guess.
Questions? How do I deal with the different lawsuits? Sense of humor. It's the only way through life. When I got like subpoenaed to Supreme Court last year and faced with imprisonment for making a YouTube video about Cali, it seems. Like, what do? You gotta laugh at it. You know, otherwise you're just like, well, it's fucked. I might as well kill myself. Like, you'll give up. So he's gotta have a sense of humor, so I'm like, how can I troll this? So I dressed up. I don't give a fuck if it's on camera anyway, but just hope it's on YouTube.
That's like...
I dressed up in my old man mask. I've got all the fucking... they had literally sent this much paperwork to our front door, a private investigator, like 5 times a day trying to get us. They would... wait down the street in cars, waiting for us to get home. We actually had to leave our house, get an Airbnb down the road, trying to serve us papers.
Yeah, we thought we could avoid being served papers, and we realised that no, you can't avoid it. They eventually catch up with you.
And so they served them finally, and then I thought, fuck it, this is a waste of paper in my house. So I got them all on my bike, rode to the lawyer's office, dressed up in Uncle Chester. Uncle Chester walked inside, put them on the thing, and walked back out.
And they sent me an email saying, we know that you dropped it off.
So all the fucking lawyers in that office, you know, it's all serious, the Supreme Court, it's $150,000 lawyers, and Uncle Chester drops it off. Like, it's just fucking with them. And I'll turn up the court with my Go Vegan shirt on while my bike eating a banana. You know, so it's just a sense of humour. You know, I wanted to go and burn the house down and smash the windows, but that's not really going to do much.
So you're only defending yourself? You didn't require the help from any lawyer?
At first, we both agreed that we were going to get a lawyer. And then eventually, I kept the lawyer and Harley dropped the lawyer because I had a property in my name. You know what I mean? They could totally drag me through the court, take my property. You know what I mean? So
I didn't
Harley didn't have anything in his name, so he had more freedom to be all like, whatever. But I had some, you know. I had a lot to lose.
So,
and they would win because they're multi-millionaires, you know, so they have more money than I do.
So what I did is I wrote to Toby via Instagram and said, Toby, I've got in front of he signed an affidavit saying he hadn't taken steroids. And I never said he did, I just said he looked like he had. You know, and so he said, I've never used steroids. But so I wrote to him and said, well, we've got some mutual friends to find that amusing. And within a few hours, his lawyers contacted Fred and said, look, let's not go forward. Because when you sign an affidavit, you've never taken steroids, and you look like you're taking steroids, you've gone from 60 kilos to 90 kilos, and you're ripped, then that's a pretty foolish thing to do. So, yeah, I don't like lawyers.
But at the end of the day, it's good to not have a property in your name. You know, if you're going to put out stuff on the internet, that might get you in trouble. Because you might just go up against someone who's like, infinitely rich.
You have to be pretty unlucky.
They drag you through the court, and no one will have any money left at the end of the day. Like defamation's really difficult like that.
Yeah, it's a tough one, but like Kayla and Toby, they're multimillionaires, so if you can survive being sued by Kayla and Toby, you're doing pretty good, because they've got a lot of money, you know, so I can't think of anyone to be worse sued by.
And you get in touch with YouTube instead, and reaching with freedom of speech and
Oh, YouTube doesn't, they don't really do much. It goes to court. And they
have to sue you.
They do what the judge says.
So it's a win, they have to sue you, and it's unlikely.
And they have to win.
Over one video, you know.
Most people don't have that sort of money to sue you. Like,
and they might not win.
And they're not, unless they're like Cal it seems. And even then, it's going to be bad publicity for them.
Yeah.
So.
What would have been the maximum prison sentence should it come down to
that? What for? For defamation?
Yeah.
No. Yeah. You're not going to do prison time.
Right. Yeah. No, the prison time would be for going against the Supreme Court injunction.
Yeah, contempt they might court. Like try and scare you, put you in jail for a couple of days maybe. Like,
but my videos are still up.
Yep.
My videos I made about Cal are still up. So, fuck them.
I have another question.
Yeah, you're lucky.
Do you both feel like you've reached your athletic potential, or do you still think that there's still like another 2-3 years where you're going to continue to do longer rides, go faster up the mountain? Like, do you see yourself aging in any regard, or do you find yourself getting faster?
Well, we're getting older. Can we get faster? For sure. There's like there's a kidney clinic near Mayamol that sells EPO. For 4 to 6 week cycle, I could be doing sub 30s up here.
Yeah.
4 to 6 weeks, but
that's not
natural. Oh, it's EPO's
natural. You know what I mean. That's not natural. Way to do
but
I don't think that's what he's
like. Yeah, for sure. There's always ways to get fitter, because you can do like, you know, you might not get faster at dose tip, but you might get to the top and be less gas. Or you could do it again. Things like that. So there's a lot of ways to measure fitness. Infinite ways. You measure fitness by, can you back it up again the next day? Or can you go longer that day? Or can you go home for a big ride and still be productive at work or your relationships? So there's always ways to get fitter, for sure. And I think it depends where you start as well. If you're like a gun Olympic level athlete at age 20, then it's probably going to be pretty hard to beat that, because you're really like supernatural level. But if you're like most of us here and not Olympic standard, golden level standard, then there's always room for improvement. And fitness can be measured in other ways, like how about you helping other people get fit? You know, are your fitness skills, is that a template that other people can use, things like that? So fitness can be measured a lot of things. It can be cardio, it can be strength, it can be your mental fitness. You know, you're mentally fit.
What about things like RAM or Race Across America? Any that kind of stuff interests you in the future?
Would I do Race Across America? Race Across America is basically a bike race where you're on your bike and you have a team car following you, support van, and you just start east to west and west to east, and whoever's there first wins. But that's just like heaps of drugs. Like, if you're on EPO and Provigil and just crazy amount of stimulants, you want to be like pack filler. So to win a RAM, you got to be doped hardcore.
But plus $8,000.
What's that?
Just to do it?
No, no, not just to do it, but to win it.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't want to do RAM and finish like mid pack. People go, oh, look at that. And the vegan got beat.
Yeah.
If I'm going to do RAM, I'm going to win it. And to win it, you have to use EPO and drugs, 100%. 100%. That's got the winners. And there's no prize money for RAM. It's just like a rich man's race, where people aren't that good enough to be pro, but they want to do something else. And so they just get on the gear.
That'd be an achievement if
you don't have to complete it. Oh, for sure. Yeah. I'd rather just ride across America with no solo.
Mm-hmm.
Or do that Trans-America Continental race. You know, that's cool. No support, just doing it. But even the winners are using drugs. Whenever there's a prize, you know, whenever there's like a finish line, a competition, people just get tempted to use shit. You know, it's just human nature.
Probably be like awesome
to do that
with like a group of friends.
There you go. Bingo. You know, like it's, whenever, that's just human nature. to beat each other, and that's good, but then it gets out of balance, and then drugs come into it, and then it just gets all twisted, and then money comes into it, and once money comes into it, it just gets all corrupt.
Okay, thinking of drugs, how is the creatine working?
What is it? Creatine is, it's like your body produces, 99% of creatine on the market is vegan. I haven't had no real difference.
Retain water, right?
You can retain a bit of water. But it depends how much you're taking. I'm just experimenting with it, like it's, you know. I would say of all the drugs, what's that? Creatine's like a little, it's not a protein. It's like a, I don't know, I'm seeing it says creatine. I'm not a biochemist.
I think your body produces.
Your body produces it.
Yeah.
And all the stuff in the shops is all synthetic. That's why I love all those bodybuilder guys. They say, oh, I need to eat meat, so I wouldn't get enough creatine. It's like, don't you take creatine? Yeah, I do. And I'm like, what do you mean? Like, you eat meat for protein, but you still take creatine and protein. Like, how does that work? Oh, don't judge me. Yeah.
Help them hydrate, get more energy.
Yes, this is hilarious. You know, like.
Another question for free this time. I know that Carly is quite an adventurous guy, likes to climb mountains with a road bike. But are you interested in doing some stuff like that as well, to go with him sometimes on adventure somewhere?
Am I interested in going on adventures with Harley, like climbing mountains and that sort of thing? Yeah, definitely. Yeah, we've done that over the years. We've been, you know, hanging around together for like 9 years. So I've definitely done adventures like that. I'm kind of a little bit lazy when it comes to, you know, big, like long adventures. I did travel across Australia though, cycle across Australia, so I did that. But yeah, I'm definitely open to it. Not all the time, but occasionally.
He has
a lot of experience with bicycle.
Questions about bicycle touring, any tips? My ebook's got a lot of good tips. I've got a lot of videos about it. My cycling ebook, that is. I would say that just take your time. And the first couple of days is the hardest. Just going in a different routine, you know. You don't know where you're going to sleep. You're like, don't know where you are. You know, maybe by yourself. Or just the first day or two is the toughest. One is just, again, have enough water so you're peeing every 2 or 3 hours. Maybe don't ride in the middle of the day if you're not used to it. Just go find somewhere shady and just kick back and just watch time drip by. Smash the carbs in, like every day, and try and go to bed by sundown. And just be in the moment, man. Just eliminate time and distance remaining. Because it's like when we, the Deutsche Tech, it's Strava, it's like seconds, it's watts, it's cadence. And that's good because it teaches us different mental skills. But when you go on touring, just chill, just low wattage, just cruising around, you know, just stop and pick a snail off the road, whatever. So it's racing, Strava, is a different mentality to touring. We're still probably uploading the Strava as well, but just chilling. So I would say it's just about learning to relax the mind and eliminate time and distance remaining and be in the moment. Be present. Yes. So if you're going to do a big epic rides like Deutsche Non, should you do electrolytes? I didn't do any of that yesterday. I just drank fruit juice and Sprite, dry bananas. Have it if you want. If you feel you need electrolytes, have it. Drink some sports drink if you need to. But most of us will be getting enough salt from our vegan dinners at night time and all that. The main thing with electrolytes is what happens is people don't drink enough water, don't eat enough carbohydrate, and then they get dehydrated. And then their kidneys can't balance out their electrolyte levels. So everything's going haywire. So I would say, as long as you're pissing every 2 or 3 hours and carbing up, you don't need to worry about that, in my opinion. But if you need to drink a sports drink, that's fine too. And there's plenty of sports drinks in all the 7-Elevens here. 7-Elevens are heaven. Yeah, dry bananas are really good. You know, I had little packs of dry bananas sitting there eating them with you yesterday. It's really good. But, Doing tonight excursion, I call it doing tonight therapy. It's like dark room therapy. It's like, look at the mist coming in. The mist is trying to listen.
That is so cool.
It's doing tonight therapy. Probably yesterday, the doing tonight back way. Beautiful. so quiet, hardly any traffic. One of the best rides in the world, I think. One of the most beautiful rides in the world, but also one of the hardest.
You think you should do it the easy way first?
Yes, you have to, otherwise you won't make it. Oh, I mean, unless you've got mountain bike gears. Then yeah, if you got mountain bike gears and lights, do it 24 hours. Yeah, definitely mountain bike gearing would be good for that one. But I would recommend before someone does Doi Tanon is do Doi Pui twice in a row. Go up, come down, go up, come down. And if you can do that, then you've got a good chance of Doi Tanon. Because the thing with Doi Tanon as well is it's a long day and it's hot and you're in traffic. So if you're not focusing, you can have a bad accident. So you want to have stamina with Doi Tanon. You might not be the fastest person in the world, but you want to have stamina so you can pay attention to the road. So when you're dehydrated under carb, you're sort of like, oh, I don't care anymore. Then, oh. That's when a lot of crashes happen, is fatigue. And a good thing in Thailand, if you're really fucked, you're just going to get a hotel. $10. No shame in that.
You can break up Doi Tanon into 2 days. You can stay
yeah.
What's the town at the bottom of Doi
Tanon? Chum Tong.
Yeah,
Chum Tong.
You can like go there, like, take an easy day, go there, and then like wake up at the base of it.
Yeah.
And then go up and down, and you need to stay there the second
yeah.
night.
Yeah. And I would say doing it tonight at the end of the month would be better because you got some K's in your legs and you're used to the heat. You know, you worked out your bike and things like that. And I'd recommend doing it probably twice in a row because otherwise, you want those experiences to be good. You know, you don't want your doing it on virginity to be too much pain. You're gonna get fisted the first time. Yeah.
When it comes to when you began riding, when you went on like long rides, were there anything you employed mentally to help with mental fortitude, so you can continue and persevere and go through?
Good question. So mental tips to pursue to keep going on long rides. That's like anything in life. I had a tattoo back in 2004. It's called PMAR, positive mental attitude regardless. I don't know why I live by that, but it was a good reminder. Especially when I first got into touring. So I'd ride across Australia and you'd be like, you know, 200 k's the next stop and you ran out of food and water and it's like, ah. And it just reminded just to chill and be present. And just eliminate time and distance remaining. And understand that today, somewhere in the world, there's going to be maybe a few thousand people that will step on landmines, you know, or get a machete chopped on the leg or whatever, and they'll be losing their limbs. So we haven't got too bad, you know. Like yesterday, I'm doing tonight, and I was thinking, oh man, I haven't got the right gearing, it's like, I feel a bit under the weather, I've only just got in Thailand, and I have all these things in my head, I'm like, just relax, man, just be present, just slow down a bit more if you need to, you know? And before I knew it, I was at the top. You know, I was at the top, so it's just about staying present, just stay relaxed, and enjoy the present moment. How do you stay motivated doing the same thing every day? It's like it's passion. You know, I want to make a difference in the planet. You know, so I'm here to make a difference, and that requires repetition. It's the same questions. It's the same emails. I've got over 28,000 questions on Tumblr I haven't answered yet. It's all the same stuff every day. It's like riding a bike. Your legs don't go sideways or square. It's a circus. Millions of repetitions. So when you understand what it takes to get the result, then you do that. You don't worry about what it, you know. I'll never look down and go, my legs are still going in fucking circles. Like, fucking this is boring. So I don't ever say, I got asked that question fucking an hour ago. Like, why are you, like, it's just, you got to have a purpose. And you got to understand what it takes to get it done. And just do it. And have fun with it. I love trolling, I love helping people help themselves. And I just see the impact it's having. And yeah, sure, I think the planet's fucked and it's ever gonna get better, but you may as well have a crack. You know?
So do you have 10 pages to reply?
No.
No?
I've got like a cut and paste for one reply and that's it. Yeah. And that's like mark your seat post with a whiteout pen, mark your cleats with a whiteout pen, that sort of stuff. Yeah. You know. That's the only template I've got. Yeah, so that's the only template you've ever seen me use. But yeah, it's just boom.
You have a question. How do you
decide
what you want to do right now?
what's one of your greatest achievements? This event.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you can get people to come. It's a long way for a lot of people. They're taking time off work, away from their family, away from their partners, away from school, quit their job, whatever. They're 16 or they're 50 with kids at home.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing.
The people come over and they want to hear us.
Yeah, that's very flattering. That's like crazy. Yeah, I'm very grateful for that. Yeah. And riding across Australia by myself.
Yeah.
That's definitely, yeah.
I mean, if I was in a wheelchair today and lost my use of my legs and my arms, I think what would keep me alive, the fact I could never ride my bike again, would be that I could still contribute on social media. You know? And that for me is like, that's what I live for now. So that's why I don't even train that much anymore. And yes, I think, in fact, it's a good day, but I could be on the computer right now helping people. But with Strava, and I can make a video about my ride yesterday. So that made me want to keep riding.
I love your climbing videos, man.
Yeah, yeah.
The power and cadence, yeah. And they're entertaining.
Yeah, that's right. Well,
I've heard a lot of the new cyclists, like the psychology of the climb and stuff. They're good.
Yeah, I've got some more coming out. So whenever I'm suffering on those rides, I think of the YouTube audience. I think I've got to hold the wheel because there's people on YouTube who want to. There's people who want to see me get dropped.
You, right?
And there's ones who don't want to see me get dropped, so I've got to hold the wheel.
Yeah.
So it's just about, you know, finding what you love and doing that. And it does feel good helping people. And yeah, sure, you help people and people spit in your face or whatever. Some people do anyway, but if you focus on that, you'll be like, you never want to help people again. It's like when I help a scorpion across the road, 100% of the time, the scorpion's going to want to bite me, you know? And should that prevent you from helping? I don't believe it should. Some people go, you fucking stupid scorpion, like, step on it, I was just trying to help you. But that's like, just because scorpions sting doesn't mean givers should stop giving. Obviously, you can calibrate and, you know, read people better, but just keep giving, man. Like yesterday, there was a cow, and I was going to cut it free, but I couldn't get close to it. You know, it sort of like stepped, like it was tied up with the nose, and I put my knife out, and it sort of would run away from me. And then so I grabbed the thing and tried to pull it, and it was pulling back. And so there's a chance this cow's going to ram me. So I couldn't really cut it. I didn't want to cut the rope with it still in its face. You know, I wanted to cut it off the face because it would go in the forest and then it would get caught in something, you know, and that's no fun. So I wanted to cut it off its actual muzzle or not at all. But it didn't want me to do that. And because the cow's so big, you can't just grab a fucking cow in a headlock. It's going to throw you.
I'm going to stick your fangs into it, man.
So I just had to ride off, you know. But, and make sure no one was watching. So you just got to do what you got to do. Do what your nature is, you know. Yeah, the end game, the Venus Project, Zeitgeist, all that stuff. I think it's really awesome. I think it's really good, but I think humans are too fucked up for that to make that work. Even in their vegan community, your biggest opponents will be fellow vegans. So you could have an eco village, a Venus Project, but there'll be so much infighting. It won't work. But there'll be power, there'll be money, there'll be like sex, there'll be just like politics. That's just, humans are fucked. Like,
well, the Venus Project,
it'll get corrupted. It's humans, man.
What currency do they use? It's a resource-based
fruit,
economy.
It's,
so
it's
always
not money,
a currency
it's
that
fruit.
Play eventually.
I think it's awesome.
Artificial intelligence will do all the work for us. So we don't have jobs, and then materials will be made from that. Then China ship would be lasting 5,000 years, and then we all share everything.
I think it's got.
So we don't have to have possessions. It's a nice idea.
But in my opinion, it's a great idea, but it's not reality. It's never going to happen. And even if it did happen, humans, we're too fucked.
Right now, there's no way.
I just think we've got too many mental issues as a society. So I think it's awesome. It's beautiful, and it's great that people have that imagination. But you know, we've got the Catholic Church or the churches or the queens and kings, the billions and zillions, and 27,000 kids today will die from starvation. Humans just love power. We get power and money, we get corrupted. And the Venus Project requires that we give up money and power. That's never going to happen. People would rather kill each other than give up power and money. So it's like what we could do, what we should do, but it's not what we could do or will do, in my opinion. I think, it's, you know, like you see, like our biggest opponents, you know, like when we were getting sued in prison, well, not in prison, when we were getting, every time we go to court or something, there's vegans and pop go, yeah, sucked in, doing our own freely, like, it's not meat eaters making these videos.
I'm a vegan and I don't agree with freely enduring data.
And a lot of times people would help out. Like even Fully Raw Christina, like I helped her get on YouTube. I would tell her about clothing and wear. I tell
her
like
so much. You know, it's crazy.
I got hundreds of emails from her.
So much.
And when Kayla was suing us, Kayla went to LA shortly after.
Like, final one.
You know, so it's just not gonna happen, you know. In my opinion, which is fucking crazy.
It'll be like 200-300 years or something.
Nah, humans are.
But you still have to keep the faith. You
gotta keep the faith.
Yeah. I have to say we're fucked, and that's it.
Yeah, no.
I mean, if the vegan movement reaches a critical mass and everybody goes vegan. You know what I mean? Like, the potential, we don't know the potential.
Humans can't even go vegetarian, let alone vegan, let alone Venus Project. Yeah?
What about, what is your opinion on the lab meat that they're growing?
Yeah, I think that's a good potential, for sure. For the people who go...
If it saves lives.
Yeah, I want to...
That's a potential that, like, the whole world
could
go towards.
Yeah.
For sure.
That's...
It'll happen, you know? Those things will become cheaper meats, like...
It has to happen if we go forward as a species.
Plant-based meats and eggs will become cheaper and the whole world will be vegan.
But I mean, like, vegan movement is accelerating so fast. Like, it's crazy. It since social media, it is just... Like, really? Instagram is just, like, girls everywhere, you know? Like, vegan chicks everywhere.
7% of Israel is vegan.
Yeah,
right?
that's fantastic. I mean, the potential's there. So like, social media is still so young.
Who knows what the future holds?
That's
really.
Right, we don't know. Like.
We can speculate, but all that matters is what we can do now, today, and all of us can bang it out on social media. All of us here can earn $200,000 a year on social media, easy. Some of you are $1 million a year, but all of us can do $200K a year, pretty easy. 100%. Yeah. Like, literally, if I had you, hypothetically, it's not going to happen though. There's not enough time. You know? But hypothetically, if I was with you every single day, from 9 to 5, over your shoulder, you did everything I told you to do with no like but you just fucking said okay, you did that. I guarantee every single person here I can have at least $200,000.
It's not very hard. It's just like thumbnails, title, content, like just do celebrity videos. Since I started doing celebrity videos, my channel has just gone like crazy. I think probably a lot of you have seen that. It's gone from like 4 million views to like when I was in LA it was like 18 million for the month. Crazy.
YouTube's printing money, basically. Like
anyone can do it. I'm not special. It's just like, just do it.
Are you gonna do other parody videos of recipes of other YouTubers?
Oh, did you watch my parody, the Ingrid Nielsen?
That
was awesome. Yeah. But like that sort of quality, like, you know, the people I'm staying with, they're amazing, and they're like, let's set it up exactly the same. And I'm not so good at that. Maybe I'll do some more parodies because it's got like nearly 500,000 views or something. Yeah. So it was good.
Even if it gets 20 views, it's worthwhile.
Yeah, you've got to appreciate every single view you get. Because that creates a ripple effect. You know what I mean? Those people, the person who's watching you tell someone else, and they tell their friends, and spreads the vegan movement further. So.
It's too easy to like compare yourself to arseholes, other people.
Yeah. We started in exactly the same place as you guys are.
Not with cycling, you know, I used to be so slow.
Not even worse, actually. Like, it was harder for us, because we're at the start of the vegan movement.
Yeah. Yeah, when we started, man, like there was no vegan movement on YouTube, really. There was like a couple of punches, like Kevin Gianni and all the market, vegan for marketing reasons only. But there was nothing like today.
I was one of the first vegan channels.
5 years ago.
You came on a year later.
Yeah. Well, I uploaded videos before you did.
I deleted some of my early videos.
Why? Actually. Why did you delete it?
Because like I was self-conscious at the time and I thought I was looking at my body going, oh my God, you're too fat, you're not going to change, blah, blah, blah. And I didn't want to put that out as like a fat thing and whatever. So I ended up deleting those videos, which was stupid in hindsight, but you know, I did it at the time. But I joined up really early and we were like some of the first channels.
Who knows? Yeah, that's it, man. Who knows Craig?
Craig Hunt.
Carved up vegan.
Carved up Craig.
Yeah, Carl, who's seen his weight loss transformation last year? You know what I mean? Like,
amazing.
When he came last year at the Q&A and he was just like so out of shape and huffing and puffing. And I'm like, where'd you come from? Like, you look like you'd ridden from Deutsch not. And he goes, oh, it's 2Ks down the road. And he was looking like I have a heart attack. And I was thinking, in my head, I was thinking, fuck, man, like, I'm irresponsible. This kid's going to die. Yeah. I should send him home or
where
something.
Where is he?
He's in Norway. He's got a girlfriend from the community. So, but Craig in a year you like became OCD and no taxis, etc., or just like riding the bike everywhere around. It took me a while before we got up here. And then the first time he came up here, he crashed on that corner. He was so heavy and out of shape. His front lifted off the ground at that steep bit. And there was this little guy, Danny Glass, behind him, and he almost crushed Danny. And Danny's like, oh, skinny boot. So he was literally like Humpty Dumpty. He fell backwards. He fell down the embankment, hit his head, lucky he had a helmet on. And, you know? But he laughed at that. Yeah. He laughed at it. It didn't deter him. He got up and went out again.
And what was his time when he first went? Like 3 hours or something. And now he does like 44?
Something, 47, something crazy.
I think it's 44 or something.
You know, like you have to double check. But his progress is...
48. Yeah,
like,
that's awesome.
You know, like it's just epic to see that. But if you look, and that's cool because you can see his YouTube progression. You can see his first videos and see the comments. Hey, dude, what are you doing, mate? You look like you stayed a child. To now, where they're like, fuck, mate. You know, I get emails regularly from people saying, oh, you know, this Craig guy, you know, he's really inspired me. Because people see us and, like, we're not that relatable for some other people. But they see people like Craig, that's more relatable, you know? Because he's not starting off as super fit or all this stuff. So he's starting off at a different level, so this is great. Everyone's got somewhere to show, but Craig's an extremely good example
of Craig potential. Helped me a lot here.
What's that?
Craig helped me a lot here. He helped me with the mountain, showed me everything.
Yeah, he's a good guy, man. He got a vasectomy. He's just grabbing the lifestyle. It's not my lifestyle. It's just a good lifestyle. You know, he loves it, man. I wish he was here. What's that?
A lot.
How much can you improve in a month? Like, be objective, like.
Yeah, are you going to be riding every day?
Well, what's the goal? Where are you at now? Give me some numbers to play with.
Yes, 100%.
So 54 now, can go sub 50 by then. And yeah, for sure.
Can you go sub 40?
Sub 40?
Maybe not sub 40.
Yeah, for sure you go sub 50. The secret with a doi satam, the secret with life, is when the breathing gets hard or life gets hard, stay relaxed. Remember, you were on that wheel before, did that help when I said relax? A little bit?
For a second.
Yeah. But you did really good, man.
I did alright.
Really? I was thinking, fuck, he's still here, this is pretty good. I was increasing the power just to see how long he could go for. And just by relaxing, your breathing slowed down, you got more oxygen, and you can keep going a bit longer. Yeah. Bingo. Yes. Whenever your breathing goes, like, you can let it go there, but then just drop it back. You know, don't be afraid to breathe hard, but then just like bring it down. Slow, deep breathing. Stay strong and relaxed. And that's a big one. Like, see, with Chris Froome, all those guys, like, they're really slow, strong, deep breathing, relaxed. Relaxed face. And have an open mouth as well. I saw some people today with their mouth shut. If you want to make it harder, have a mouth shut. Like, for me to climb the mountain with my mouth shut, it's going to take an extra 10-15 minutes because it's just so much harder because you're not getting enough oxygen to your body. And oxygen is what burns the fat. 3 kilos of oxygen burns 1 kilo of fat. So if your mouth's shut, that's good if you want to keep fat in your body. If you want to expel fat or burn fat, keep your mouth open at all times. I know in yoga, they teach people to have a mouth shut. But we're not doing yoga. We're riding our bikes up mountains, you know. So if you want to do, like, downward dog, that's good, but it's not going to get you fit. So your mouth open on the hills makes it heaps easier. Just get oxygen in. Especially this time of morning, it's the air's fresh, it's the tree oxygen. Just suck it in. Suck it in.
Wasn't you on the bike this morning with the shoes? Like,
normal.
Like giving it like a lot of effort? You are amazing. I'm telling you. When you get clip-ins, like, you're going to be so fast.
What
gearing do you have?
Like
28
in the
middle.
Okay, I think it's alright, Vicky. Maybe. Not this last bit.
Yeah, the last bit was.
Oh my god, my dress was so wobbly.
Yeah,
this girl was like
killing
it.
Yeah.
This is like.
She's dropping us, hey.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes, yes.
We had clips in, she had just her sneakers. We were trying to keep up with her.
Yeah.
Yeah, good job.
So it's really good to see people improve.
Yeah, speaking of shoes, we just run mountain bike shoes. They're easy to walk around in.
Yeah, walking.
You can use whatever you like, but we like mountain bike shoes.
I see a lot of mountain bike shoes.
Yeah, a lot of shops back home, they say, oh, you know, get a road bike, get a road shoe. But, yeah, they're not walking downstairs, they're not really doing the adventure cycling sort of stuff. I have road shoes at home, but to Thailand, I just brought my mountain bike shoes because there's a lot of walking and, you know, stuff like that. So I prefer the mountain bike shoe.
Do you really recommend
clip-ins? Yeah. Because clip-ins, I do recommend clip-in pedals for sure. And the pedal, best pedals to get would be the Shimano A530. Because it's a double-sided pedal, so you got flat on one side, you got clip on the other. So when you're riding around town, you just want to ride your sneakers. Or it's a good pedal to learn how to ride with clippings as well. Because if you're not too confident, you just ride in the flat bits. But all you have to do with the clippings is just clip it in at home. Just be sitting on the wall, just clipping 100 times each foot. 100 times each foot until you're confident, and then go out in the traffic. What people do is they go, all right, I'll clip in shoes. Oh, that's a busy road, let me go and practice. How's the traffic like? Can I hold it up? You know, that's cool. It's like, oh, my collarbone's broken. Oh, clipping shoes, like, we practice at home before we go out. You know, it's just common sense.
What happened to your center-mounted shoes that you had
in these? What happened to my midfoot cleat shoes? They just, I don't have for 6 years, and eventually they just cracked. So the guy who makes them doesn't make new shoes anymore, so.
Did you go back?
Special. Yeah, I would, but it's just hard to get custom shoes, really. Midfoot, so.
Do you still prefer midfoot?
No, my cleats are slammed back and I'm going to jewel these out and boot them back. But it's personal preference. It's not something I recommend for everyone. It's not like diet and YouTube and early nights. That's different, you know. So that, we'll do one more question. It's 9:10. We've gone over a bit, but one more question.
Are you
going to
have dinner tonight?
what we'll do is, imagine if we all went to one restaurant. If we don't say where we're going to turn up, otherwise it'll just be too hectic for everyone. So just,
everybody.
Yeah,
Happy
yeah.
Green's good.
Not
everybody, no.
So there's Happy Green, there's Naya Mall downstairs, there's Taste of Heaven, there's a lot of places. Just spend money. Another thing as well, never complain about bugs in your hotel room or your food, because they'll go, no worries, and they'll come in, they'll spray the fuck out of it. And they use toxic shit in Thailand, so never, if you see ants on anything, just turn a blind eye. Never complain about bugs and mosquitoes because they'll just spray the heck out of us. One more. Lewis.
Cheap Muay Thai
gyms. There's always new ones popping up. I would recommend just doing one-on-one training. And then that way you're getting like the best training. Depends if you just want to go kick bags, there's heaps of gyms. But if you want one-on-one, and because when I do Muay Thai, I don't do jump rope, I don't do push-ups, I don't do sit-ups. I'm not there to get fit, I'm there to learn skill and spar. So what I would recommend to get the best value for money is just get one-on-one training with someone so you can spar and do pad work. That way, because when you're doing skipping, like, what's the point of that? You do it on the bike. So I would say just look for a one-on-one trainer, and there's heaps of them around. Maybe 300 baht to 500 baht, depending. All right, so see you tomorrow. So again, at the bottom, we meet at 6:30. Get a head start. Never wait for me or Freely because we're going to be banging up the mountain.
Thanks for coming, everyone.
Take all your rubbish. Take it in. Take it in.
Still out on the way down.
Yes.
Skip the pepperoni, keep the dairy aside. I know what you're thinking, that's bruschetta. Nah, we got the soy cheese, counterfeit cheddar. Hook up the nachos, guacamole tacos, avocado sushi, domo arigato. What do you eat? What about meat? What about protein? What about cheese? Can you eat fish? Do you eat this? Would you eat?